What's up, guys? Baker Boys Outdoors here today, and we are in the pond right now. As you can see, we're in the paddle boat right now. We're trying to get some bullheads out of the pond because tomorrow or Thursday, so today is Tuesday, so Wednesday or Thursday, we're going to be trying to set some bank poles, and our bait is going to be the bullheads. The bugs are terrible right now, but we can't let that bother us. So in the rest of the video, we're going to be trying to show you guys how to bait. So like hook up your bait on a bank pole, good places to set up your bank poles. And then if we catch anything on our bank poles, we're gonna show that. And then we're also going to teach you guys, or kind of go through the process on how to skin and fillet a catfish. But I'm gonna stay out here and fish for a little longer, and if I get anything, I'll show you guys. I also want to show you guys that the paddle boat that we're fishing in, I got a rim from the anchor, and then it's got the holes in it, so we can put the poles in there. We got a little storage back here, the corn I was using, and bread, and then a live bait bucket. And I got a trap over there. I don't know if you can see it. It's like right there. But we're gonna fill it up with bread, and we're gonna try and catch some smaller bullheads or like bluegill in there. But we know there's fish in here because last weekend me and Jared were here, and we caught, I think he caught six bullheads, and I caught one or two, so he definitely caught more than me. But we're gonna try to get the trap here. It's right there. It's still floating. I just made this, and this is the first time it's been in the water. It's really hard to steer this paddle boat, but it's right there. I gotta fill it up really quick here. Okay, so we might be able to get the trap here. This is always sketchy. Gotta reach this line here. I'll use one of the fishing poles. There it is. Doesn't look like we have anything yet, or right now, which makes sense. There's no bait in here. But basically, you're just gonna throw the bread in that hole, and then throw her back in. So I just got done putting all this stuff in here. So basically, it's focusing on that. There's bread, and then I rolled up some bread to make it last longer. Goldfish and like Cheez-Its that have salt on them that attracts a fish. And then behind all that is some corn over there. And I'm just going to throw this in. It's not going to sink all the way, but it'll probably sink overnight. So we'll get to you in the morning because I won't be doing any more fishing for the rest of the day. What's up, guys? Baker Boys Outdoors here. And this is the next day. Actually, we didn't go fishing Thursday at all. Yeah, let's get some lighting. Oh. we didn't go fishing at all Thursday. And it's late Friday. What time is it? Probably like 9? Let's look at the clock.
9:10.
You heard the man. Anyways, we're out on the pond. Same pond as yesterday. And Jared just caught this mondo of a bullhead. And we got
the live well.
Hillbilly live well. We're all rigged up here on the boat. But we're just getting these bullheads to set bank poles either tomorrow or the next day, so Saturday or Sunday. And we're going to keep fishing. We're kind of slim on time, so we're not going to be able to take video the entire time because we don't have much room on this little paddle boat with both of us. But we're going to get to fishing, and we'll update you every time we get a fish. All right, guys, so Jared just secured the bag with this. You're shining the light. with this Mondo. Cold so bag. This will be good catfish bait. Hold them closer this way so it doesn't fall out. That we've had experience. But anyways, we're going to throw them in the Hillbilly live well, and we're going to get to more fishing. We'll have a count at the end, show you guys. All right, guys. Jared just caught another one. He's beating me already if we were in a challenge, but that's not today's video, but we got another one. So we're going to put him in the Hillbilly live well. That's three bank poles that we can bait at least once, so we're on a roll. We're going to keep fishing.
Ow, he's biting me. Let go. I'm trying to help you.
Again? Well, not really. We're going to use this bait.
We'll help him for now.
But anyways, we're going to get back to fishing, and we'll do a count at the end. All right, guys. Jared just caught another one. I've been cutting up these bluegills and using them as bait. They're working real well.
Oh, my God. Swarming.
Yeah, we're going to take the lights off. We'll get back with you. All right, guys. So, as you can see in the background, where it at? That's the moon. That's pretty cool. So, anyways, Jared's in the water over there. You can't see him. But let's just say that we've had at least 12.
Holy mackerel, dude. Yeah.
We've had at least 12 fish come off. I think we're up to five or six bullheads right now. But
this whole boat is shifting.
We're going to keep fishing, so we'll do a count when we're done. But I just want to show you guys that moon. It's over there nice and bright. But yeah, we'll get back with you later. What's up, guys? It's the next day. Got a skeeter in my face. It's the next day. We're at the river. Got the bullhead. We got the bank poles. I know.
Dude, I got one.
Good. We're gonna set the bank poles with bluegill, bullhead, and Jared just caught a leopard frog.
Dude.
So I'm gonna show Jared rigging up the fish. All right, guys. So Jared's hooking him up. He's not gonna be too happy about this, but what you're going to do is you're going to hook him. Let's get...
He's
there you go.
Me. He's got me.
He's biting you. You're going to hook him right underneath the spine. And that way that the fish can still move in the water and get oxygen until it gets eaten. But we're going to take the pole. We're going to set it right on this bank right here because there's... Oh, watch your step, Jim. Anyways, because this channel comes out and once... It's probably going to rain soon. So this will fill up and little bait fish will swim through here and go out into the river most likely. So we're going to set it right here. Not that far out because it'll probably fill up with water.
Right here,
yeah, like here. Let me get up here without slipping.
He's not looking too good, man.
It's fine.
He's paralyzed.
It's fine. He'll adapt. Just shove it in like right here. What you want to do with the bank poles is shove them in at an angle and not straight up or anything, because you want to get as much length out of that line into the water. Anyways, this is a Wapsie River, if you guys were wondering. But I'm going to...
Don't tell them.
Why not? But I'm going to try and shove this thing in deeper and get the line in. But we'll We'll show you when we hook up the other fish.
Dude, you don't want him on rock bottom. You see that?
He's yeah, fine. What he said.
He's fine right there.
All right, guys. We just got the bank pull in. Little Jimmy's down there in the water. Just kind of cruising. Hopefully that'll hold, but the banks are really, really dense. They're not soft at all. Jared's over here. Rigging up his pole. The hook that we used on that bank pole was just like a regular J hook. I think it was a 6-aught. I'm not sure on that, but it's in that area. I know it's a J hook. But are you using a circle hook?
Topwater again.
He is? Okay. What hook are you using?
Circle man.
Circle hook, right there. And we're using a leopard frog. Hook them right through the throat, or like the bottom there, because the cartilage is the strongest in their mouth. That's why we're having a difficult time hooking them. Your discretion advised. All right, so we're just gonna leave them in the chin, or like in the mouth. We'll let you guys know how that goes, but that one's in down there, and then this one's about to be in. So when we get to the next one, we'll show you guys. All right, guys, so I just cut one of the bullheads in half. It's pretty graphic, but we're gonna throw them on the hook.
All right, gotcha.
So I got it on the ground, and I'm just gonna hook it right underneath the spine again. And then make sure my fingers are out of the way. And then pop it right through. And then kind of push it up the hook a little bit. Like right. That. So you can have a place for the catfish to get hooked on. And it will fall back down a little bit in the water. But setting that hook higher helps it not slip up the, or slip down the hook. Alright, guys, so I just got this other bank pole set up. What I did on this one is I cut right behind his top barb and I cut his head off. I don't know if we're gonna use the head for bait because I don't know if that'd be too hard to set the hook. But we're gonna set the bank poles along here and behind me here. And there's a big drop off here, so it should be a good spot. Mosquitoes. All right, we're gonna set these and then move upstream. Downstream. So we're gonna, yeah, we're gonna set these and we'll get back with you guys. All right, guys, so currently we're running from the mosquitoes, but we've got this one in, and then where she be? That one back there. We got those in, and then, oh, there's also a small one like that right next to this big one up here. The small ones have decent sized bluegills on them, but we are down to one bank pole and we're gonna set it with another bullhead. We shouldn't have to show that because if you guys were interested in how to set a bank pole with the bullhead, that's, you only need to see it once really because it's kind of graphic, especially for YouTube and stuff now, but I hope it helped you guys out. So we're gonna go ahead and set this last bank pole.
Joseph, they're in my ears.
I know. And we'll get with you guys when we're done. All right, guys, so we're back in the truck. We escaped all the mosquitoes, they're terrible. But we set all the bank poles and this is gonna be the whole entire video of us catching the fish and setting the bank poles, teaching you guys how to hook them up. And if we catch anything, we might add this on, or might add that on to this video, or we might make a separate video on how to check your bank poles. Next time you see us, we'll probably be checking the bank poles, so we'll let you know on the video. Yeah.
Bye. Love you.
Well, guys, these are the conditions we have to go through to get back here.
Pretty insane. Gotta keep her in four.
Grass taller than us. There's ruts all in here.
Oh yeah, there's a big one right up in here. Where's she at?
Oh, I think you just... Oh no, there she is.
Right here.
Oh. Don't mind the sombreros. Yeah. Hey. Goodbye.
Peace, boys.
Hey Panini, don't you be a meanie. Thought you wanted me to go, or why you tryna keep me teeny? I, it's a dreamy.